He said, come and learn of me.
Yes.
We didn't learn all of that. You know what? People, Brother Ron, they always get on my time. You know, you should be getting paid. Well, they didn't pay Yahshua. He's my teacher, right?
Yes, sir.
They didn't pay him. They didn't pay Paul.
Nope.
Nor Silas, nor by Barnabas. Paul said, I'm a tent maker by trade. And I'm in my handiwork paying for all these people I got with me.
Yep.
And if I need something more, I'll get a donation from Macedonia to bring over there to Jerusalem. But you don't have to pay me to do it.
Yeah.
He promised me a payday.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because I'm a pastor, don't mean I have to live like the rest of them do.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Flying around in their own Learjet, driving around in Bentley. They ain't driving. Got somebody driving for them. I'm having service and standing over here. He's my bodyguard over here. Rolling over there, my bodyguard. And Chandler's back there. He's my bodyguard. He watching the doors and they're standing there. No, I don't need all of that. I got bodyguards you can't see.
Yeah.
They're here right now.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
They have people come here and try to put voodoo on me. When we was over there at the police station having services, they put voodoo over there, mojo bag. Sacrifice a bird on the top of the building right here. They tried everything, called up on the phone, and pronounced death on me. But I'm still here.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
No weapon formed against me.
Will
prosper.
Rise up again.
Yeah, because if they rise up against me, the Father will rise up against them.
Yes, indeed.
Know ye not that I got 12 legions at my disposal?
Uh-huh.
All I got to do is call on my Father and say, hey,
yes,
I need independence to be put down.
That's right.
But I won't do that because of the love that I have in my heart for people. I want them to be saved.
Hallelujah.
See, when Minister Johnson spoke that word, and I preached about it once before, that same spirit that raised up Yahshua from the dead is in us.
Yeah.
You mean we got resurrection power in us?
Yes.
Have you ever been told that before? See, the Father wants us to understand what we have going on the inside of us. It's no longer you, but it's he that dwells in you. If you allow him to do what he can do, he got power. Let me tell y'all something. 1 Thessalonians 4:3. For this is the desire of Almighty Yah. Now see when I read that? I said, hold on a minute. He getting ready to tell us something. Because he got a desire for us, but it's not all that you see going on outside of this body. And Brother Isaac don't want to be like nobody else. So I want to find out, what is his desire for us? Y'all ready for this? Look what he said, verse number 3. For this is the desire of Elohim, your set apartness, or your kodeshness, or your holiness.
Yeah.
That's what his desire is for us, to be set apart. Come out from amongst them and be ye separate and touch not the unclean. That's what his desire is for us. He don't want us mingling with that. None of us here have a reason to be at Mardi Gras.
Yes.
With your hands up to all them pagan deities.
Uh-huh.
Screaming, throw me something. The Father's going to throw you something pretty soon. And you ain't got to raise your hand up and scream for it. You know, you're not even going to know the day that it comes.
Yeah.
Until that last trumpet sound. When the sign of the Son of Almighty Yah appears in the heavens, with a great cloud of witnesses with him. Saints don't have their hands like this. We've been waiting for him.
Yeah.
Woo, we've been waiting for him. He's going through.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
The rest of them will be running and crying out for the rocks to fall on
them.
To hide them from his face.
Yes.
And we seeking his face.
Yeah.
We have not learned what these people out here are doing. So why are we trying to be like them? Oh, come on, somebody.
Oh, yeah.
Look, look, he said, for this is the desire of Almighty God, your set apart, that you should abstain from fornication. Abstain from fornication. The first thing we think about is sex. No, you fornicate when you go out there and play with the devil in his world.
Yeah.
That's spiritual fornication.
Uh-huh.
Don't think of it just sex between man and woman. Uh-huh. It's also your relationship with the devil that you don't want to turn loose.
Yeah.
Well, we got really quiet on that one.
Yeah.
See, but you got to turn all of that loose. You can't hold on to that in him too. That's the message Brother Blackwell preached all the time. You can't serve two masters. You're going to love one and hate the other. Y'all hear me, don't you? Each one of you, verse 4, should know how to possess your own vessel in what?
Sanctification
in what?
Honor.
Or set apartness and respect. We should be able to respect ourselves.
Yes.
And the only way we can respect ourselves is if we respect Yah.
Hallelujah.
For those few little shouts I got just now. You didn't shout for me, you shout because that's the truth. Thank the Father for those little shouts. Hallelujah. For not in possession, not in passion, not in passion of lust. Let me say it again. Thank you, Father. Not in passion of lust. Like the rest of the world who don't know Almighty God. You say you know him, right?
Yeah.
I said, you say you know him, right?
Yes.
Do you know him?
Yes.
Or do you know of him? Do you know what his next move is?
No.
Do you know what his next word is? Do you know what his next action is? Do you know him? We are learning of him.
Yeah.
When you say you know him and you're not keeping his commandments, you are a liar. And the truth is not in you. Revelation 21:8 says, all liars go into the lake that burns with fire and sulfur. We got to catch up to him. Because we've been trying to catch up to everything else
except him.
We want to do what makes us feel good, what sounds good to us, or that's not right because that's not the way I see it. The Father says, I don't care how you see it, this is what's right. That's the problem right now. Well, I don't see it that way. No, you need to shut up. And listen and learn. Because he's got a lot more to teach us in a short period of time. Because I don't foresee what's going on to be going on for a long time.
Yeah.
Time is running out.
Yeah.
I even made a song about it. Time is running out on this old world. It's running out. And what are we going to do? Well, Brother Isaac, you done told us that we shouldn't be like everybody else. Then who should we be like?
Yeah.
Oh, boy, I can be. In John 14:6, the Messiah said, I am the way. Be like that. I am the truth. Be in that. And I am the life. Be in that. Because without that, no man will see the Father. Is that strong enough for us?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So if you want to strive to be like something, be like him.
Yeah.
The way, the truth, and the life. When people see you, they need to see the way, the truth, and the life. They shouldn't see Gabonzo and the drug house and the house of ill repute and this house and that. No.
Yeah.
People, when they see you, they should see Yahshua.
Yeah.
Yahshua said, when you have seen me, you have seen the Father. If his spirit is in you like we say it is, then when people see us, they should see that too.
Yeah.
Yes.
Not somebody like anybody else.
Uh-huh.
Talking like, eating like, walking like, dressing like, going where they go, doing what they do. No! It's time out for that.
Yeah.
It's time to be like our Creator.
Hallelujah.
1 Peter 2:12. 1 Peter 2:12 says, having your behavior amongst the nations good.
Yes.
So that when they speak against you as evildoers, let them by observing your good works esteem the Almighty in the day of visitation. You gotta show them what you're talking about. You can't just talk about this. You say you're living right, show them that you're living right.
That's right.
Don't let them catch you in an untoward situation.
Right.
Let them see you as a father have created you to be. Because if you're anything else, they're going to spot you. Nobody, because they're looking for some
looking for it, yes.
They're looking for just a few reasons that they don't have to do what you're doing. And they'll cause you to go back. No, they ain't going to cause you. You're going to be elected to go back.
Yeah. There you go.
To do what they do. Because that's what you want anyway.
Right.
Huh? Because if you didn't want it, you wouldn't be looking back. Maybe that's why the Creator said, if anybody put their hand to the plow and look back, they're not fit for the kingdom. We ain't got no reason to look back. Like Lot's wife. Even in the British Hobby Shop, he said, remember Lot's wife? Why did that cross over the line? Oh, that crossed over, the Ten Commandments didn't cross over. Huh? If Lot's wife crossed over, why didn't the Ten Commandments cross over? It did, thank you. Somebody know what's going on. I like that. Come on now. Then it says in 1 Peter chapter 1, verse number 13, therefore, having girded up the loins of your mind, get your mind right. Being sober, let's get sober. We've been drunk on the world. Drunk on the world's stuff. Drunk on the world's clothes. Drunk on the world's money. Drunk on the world's jewelry. We even want to ride in cars like the world with a boom, boom, boom. Shake, 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 and the bass hitting them, and the mirror shake. And by the time they're 30, they're going to be deaf.
Uh-huh.
Well, that's all for you today.
Yep.
Set your hope perfectly upon the favor that is to be brought to you at the revelation of Yahshua the Messiah.
Yes.
That's what I want.
Yes.
That's what I want.
Somebody else in here want that?
Yes.
Well, if you want that, you got to go to verse 14. You got to be obedient children.
Yes.
Not conforming yourself to the former lust in your ignorance.
Yes.
Why would you want to go back?
Uh-huh.
You got to wait for that. You got to loose.
No desire.
Instead, as the one who called you and set being set apart, so you also should be set apart in all. Your behavior.
Yeah, your life.
Because it had been written, be you set apart or holy, for I am
set apart.
So the Father said, all these gods that people are worshiping, I can set myself apart from all of them.
Yeah.
I don't want y'all worshiping me like they worship their God. I don't want you worship me like they worship Molech. I didn't ask any of y'all to sacrifice your children to me. I didn't ask you to do that. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father.
So since I've set myself apart from all them other things over there, I need you to set apart.